Hello students, how are you? Hope you all are healthy and safe at your places. I am Shweta Jain, representing Shiv Jyoti Educational Group Kota. Today, we will study Science, Chapter 6, Plants, the Producers, Part 2. So, all of you, open your books, Chapter 6, page number 50. So, children, as we have already discussed the first part of this chapter, so this is the second part of the chapter. In this part, you will learn about use and storage of food prepared, interdependence of plants and animals, balance in nature. So, let us come to the topic. Use and storage of food prepared. Children, as we have already discussed that plants are producers and they produce their food by themselves by the process of photosynthesis. Now, how they use this food and how this food is prepared, that we will discuss here. So, children, the food made by leaves through photosynthesis is in form of simple sugar. So, when during photosynthesis, plants take carbon dioxide, water and minerals, they convert it into simple sugars. So, the leaves, they prepare food in form of simple sugars. Now, these sugars is carried to different parts of the plant through the stem and branches. This we have also discussed earlier that stem and branches helps to transport this food to the different parts of the plant. Now, as we need food to grow, we need food to get energy. Similarly, all the parts of the plants also need energy for doing their work. So, this food is supplied to different parts of the plant through the stem and the branches. Now, plants use the food to grow and live. Similarly, as we need food to live and grow, plants also need food to live and grow. Now, because plants are producing this food and they use the food with what is required by them, the rest of the food they store. So, extra food is stored in roots, stems, fruits, leaves and seeds in form of starch. Now, this extra food which is prepared by them, it is now stored in the different parts of the plants. This you have studied in your previous class also, that they store their food. In some plants, it is stored in leaves. In some plants, it is stored in fruits, in some stem, roots, etc. Now, some of the examples we will see now. See. In some plants, food is stored in roots, like in case of carrot and radish. As you can see here, these are the roots that we eat. Then, in some plants, it is stored in leaves, like spinach, cabbage, etc. In some, it is stored in stem, like in potato and sugarcane. You can see here in the picture, this is the stem of the sugarcane which stores the food. Then, in some plants, it is stored in seeds like peas, kidney beans, etc. And in some plants, the extra food is stored in fruits like apple, mango and so many fruits are there which you like to eat. So, all these fruits, they store food in them. Now, we come to the next topic, that is interdependence of plants and animals. Now, as plants are living organisms, animals are also living organisms, and plants are the producers. They are producing the food. So, plants and animals, they both depend on each other. So, plants, now we will study that how they depend on each other. So, as plants are producers, so they produce food. Now, the food and they store the extra food in their different parts. Now, animals, because they cannot prepare their own food, so they use the food which is prepared by the plants directly or indirectly. So, animals depends on the plants directly or indirectly. Plants and animals depends on each other in many ways. So, plants can make their own food, so they are called producers. Animals depend directly or indirectly on the plants for their food. So, first dependence is for food. Animals depend on plants for their food. Secondly, another thing is, because during the process when plants produce their food, they also give out oxygen. So this oxygen is used by animals for breathing, and at the same time animals give out carbon dioxide when they breathe out. So this carbon dioxide when comes into the air, it is used by plants. Children, जब photosynthesis होता है तो oxygen produce होती है, and this oxygen is used by us for breathing. It makes us alive. और similarly जब हम breathe करते हैं तो we give out carbon dioxide, and this carbon dioxide is used by plants. जैसे हमने पहले पढ़ा है कि the raw materials for preparing food are carbon dioxide and water. So this raw material is provided by animals. Now children, because these are interdependent for food, so there is a chain of organisms that shows that each organism in the chain depends on the lower organism for its food. So this dependence or interdependence or this relation between plants and animals can be explained by food chain. Clear? Now there are some animals which eat only plants. So these animals are herbivores. So herbivores eat plants, and some animals are there which are called carnivores which eat herbivores. So this chain, it includes all the three things: plants, herbivores and carnivores. Let us see an example here. Now see the picture over here. So these are the plants. They take the energy from the sun in form of sunlight and produce food. Now this food is used by the herbivores, which depend only on the plants for their food because they are the plant eating animals. Now these herbivores are then eaten by carnivores. These are the flesh eating animals. They depend on herbivores, and herbivores depend on grass or plants. So directly or indirectly, all the animals depend on plants for their food. So this chain explains who eats whom. Now plants and animals helps to maintain the balance of oxygen and carbon dioxide in the environment by the exchange of gases. As we have discussed right now that plants are giving out oxygen and animals are giving out carbon dioxide. So the balance is maintained in the environment by both of these gases. Animals use the oxygen and plants use the carbon dioxide. You can see here from this picture also that these are some of the animals. Human beings, animals, they are giving out carbon dioxide by the breathing process, and this tree, it is a plant, it is taking this carbon dioxide, and in presence of sunlight it prepares food, and oxygen is also given out. So this oxygen is again used by this human being and the animals for their breathing. Now we come to the next topic, that is balance in nature. The balance between the number of plants and animals is in nature needs to be maintained. For this we need to protect both plants and animals. Now children, because both of these are very important part of our nature or part of our environment, so there should be a balance, because if there is an imbalance, then something will get disturbed. Now how this happens, that if the number of animals increase tremendously or bahut zyada animals ho jayenge, to what will happen? Plants will not be able to supply food and oxygen to fulfill their requirements. So agar bahut zyada animals ho gaye to plants itna oxygen aur food produce nahi kar payega ki unki puri requirement fulfill ho sake. In the similar manner, if the number of animals decreases to a very low number, then what will happen? The carbon dioxide which animals give out will not be sufficient for plants to produce their food. So in this way, this balance can will be disturbed. So to maintain the balance of the nature, it is necessary to protect both plants as well as animals. As plants are the very precious gift of nature to us, so we need to protect them. At the same time, to maintain the balance, we need to protect animals also. Now, there is one more interesting thing to know that in our country, every year, the first week of July is celebrated as one Mahotsav. So, children, during this period, what people do? They used to plant more and more trees. The students, now we'll mark the internal question. So, open your books and get ready with your pencils. So, first question here is, name the tiny holes present on underside of a leaf. So, answer is stomata. Now, this is given on page number 48. So, you see on page number 48 in your books, in the second paragraph, under the heading parts of a leaf, you can see the second paragraph, second line, on the underside of a leaf, there are many tiny holes called stomata. So, you mark stomata over here and write the question above the paragraph. Okay. So, now we move to next question. Which solution when added to starch turns blue black? So, answer to this question is iodine solution and it is given on page number 49. So, see open page number 49. It is given over here in the second paragraph. You can see third line, starch turns the iodine solution blue black. So, underline this line, starch turns the iodine solution blue black. Okay, and write the question above the paragraph. Now, we move to next question. In which form extra food is stored in plants? Now, answer to this is starch and it is given on page number 50. So, open page number 50 of your book and you can see here the first paragraph of your book. Under the heading use and storage of food prepared, the second last line you can see extra food is stored in roots, stem, fruits, leaves and seeds in the form of starch. So, you underline starch over here and write the question above the paragraph. Now, we come to the copy work. So, let us start with the definitions. So, first definition is chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is a green substance present in leaves. Second, photosynthesis, the process by which green plants make their own food in the presence of sunlight. Third, producers, green plants that can make their own food are called as producers. Okay, so this was all about the definitions. Now we move to answer the following questions. What are the functions of a leaf? So, first function is leaf prepares food for plants as they contain chlorophyll. Second function, leaf has tiny holes called stomata which help the plant to breathe. So, these are the two functions. Now, second question is how are the plants and animals interdependent? So, first animals depend on plants for their food. This we have studied through food chain also. Then plants give out oxygen which is taken by animals and animals give out carbon dioxide which is taken by plants for photosynthesis. Now next question, what are the raw materials needed to make food? How plants obtain these raw materials? Sunlight, water and carbon dioxide are the raw materials needed by the plant to make food. So children, there are three raw materials. They are sunlight, water and carbon dioxide. Water and minerals are absorbed from the soil by the help of their roots. Carbon dioxide is absorbed from the air through stomata and sunlight is absorbed by the chlorophyll which is present in leaves. Then we come to the next question. Draw a well labeled diagram of a leaf. Now see here, this is the diagram of a leaf and I have also explained you earlier. This is this part. This flat broad part is called as leaf blade or leaf lamina. Then you can see this tube which is running through the center of the leaf is called as main vein. And the tubes or the veins which are arising from the main vein throughout the leaf surface are called as side veins. So, this is about the structure of a leaf. Now, we come to the next diagram, that is photosynthesis. Now, you can see here, this is the diagram which is showing the process of photosynthesis. You can see three raw materials. These are water and minerals. Second is carbon dioxide and third is sunlight. So, plants are taking water and minerals from the soil through their roots. Now, this is transported through the stem to the leaves. then plants are taking carbon dioxide from the surrounding air into their leaves through stomata, and they are taking sunlight which chlorophyll absorbs, which is present on leaves, and during the process they are giving out oxygen. You can see oxygen here. So this is the complete process of photosynthesis. So students, this was all about the explanation of this chapter. Have a nice day. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.